Why does he want to bring me where he goes? Oh, and to find out the reasons why. It's enough to make you wanna try for one last night.
Estimated 6,000 to 8,000 Aboriginals in the whole Sydney region. By 1820, population had grown to 18,700. Aboriginal population was 300 heads. So it actually got absolutely decimated. And Sydney was pretty peaceful with the Aboriginals. It wasn't like other parts of Australia or other areas where there was massacres. There were in other places, but Sydney was nearly all smallpox and influenza. So it wiped out pretty fast with that disease, which is not an uncommon thing. Same thing happened in America. Canada, it's a very similar. Spanish galleon went through Micronesia apparently in the 1500s, just stopped for repairs, took off again. 98% of the people perished from diseases that those Spaniards had left as they went through. So it was a pretty sad thing for indigenous people. Ever. But back to this little cutting here, it's called Anderson's Couch. And Charles Anderson was on the, he was back in England and he was a soldier. He worked for the Queen's Surgeon. The guy copped some head injury. As a result of his work, and as a result, he goes off the rail, becomes a mental case. No such thing as helping him out in those days. And because he became a hard to manage person, or a nutcase if you want, sentenced to transportation along with the Crims to Australia as a convict and on the first fleet. And he ended up on Goat Island under George Barney, and he was probably down there cutting into the rock. And he lashed out an officer and hit an officer. And for that, he got sentenced to 1,200 lashes and was chained to this rock for 3 years and 3 months. Wow. It sort of starts to take you back to this place. It was a really nasty place. You got these poor guys, only 18 years old. No spoil his own. 3 years, 3 months, he was here languishing in this. And at the time he was languishing here, they had people hung on Fort Denison out there, which was known as Pinch Gut then, hung and gibbeted. And a gibbet means they didn't just hang them, they left them there to rot in these little cages, just as an example to others. So you've got a really nasty place with the First Fleet, so Sydney has some pretty dark roots.
When did that all turn around? When did it just...
The last convicts came in 1820 to Sydney, but they kept going for quite a lot longer than that down into Tasmania and other places. By 1820 it was starting to around a little bit. And then the modern city of today, it's really turning around. But anyway, back to Charles Anderson, he did end up shifting off to the Norfolk Island. No one knows what happened to him, but it is worth thinking about. If you're having a bad day, things not going your way, just think of this guy.
Not that bad.
Oh, yeah.
So we're not looking out to sea out that side, you know, you're getting that bubbly, you do get the you feel the ocean, even the smell. whilst this side, looking to the west, has a completely different feel about it. There's over 100 kilometres of navigable waterways this direction, all the way up to Parramatta, Lanco River. But what's really great is so much of it managed to avoid development. Again, that wall 10 is really special. You go for a walk up there too. I know how long you guys hang around Sydney, but if you want to have an urban walk, you get out to the track that goes along this foreshore and over there, over to those headlands over there. And there's parts you can just stop and think, you could be anywhere, you know? It's in really good condition with lots of trees. And they're all natives, not all natives, most of them natives. Well, Island's not a national park. There's still a commercial slipway over there, this thing down there, where the train is. That's still a bit of working harbour. It's probably the last honest bit of working harbour left. It's just a slipway. And these buildings here, they really are pretty sort of special as far as Sydney goes. Americans and English, you're the only...
Yeah.
Sometimes when I got Europeans, I kind of say, look, I know this is not a big deal for you guys, like, from England especially, you know, 1836, that's not that old for these buildings. But for Sydney, this is pretty much as far, this goes back. Now, New York is probably still, you wouldn't have a lot like that, but New York's pretty old, isn't it?
Yep.
So you probably get a fair bit of that there. But these are two of Sydney's most historic buildings. We'll have a quick look at them before we just shoot back.
Myself away. Well, I better act quick. Yeah, I better change my ways. Oh, maybe I'm wasting. Maybe I'm chasing time. Oh, come on, let's face it. I'm only ever lost in mine. Well, I got my tracing paper so that I could trace my clock. And the bastard face kept changing and the hands, they wouldn't stop. Well, I was ripping out the battery, I received myself a shock. And to add insult to injury, I could still hear tick and talk. Casio! Self a break. And I try for heaven's sake. Well, I traveled to Australia and I traveled there by train. This something might sound strange to you, but on the way I gained a day. And I wrote to tell my family and I wrote to tell my friends. I arrived home, it was lost again, and this torture never ends. Casio.